Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Heather Holyoke, and this is my friend, Desert Rose.
Number two.
My name is Heather Holyoke, and this is my friend, Ingrid the Buzzard.
Number three.
My name is Heather Holyoke, and this is my friend, Cactus Kid.
Only one of these people is the real Heather Holyoke, and is the only one sworn to tell the truth. Now let's meet our panel. Host of Let's Make a Deal, Monty Hall. Star of Mama's Family, Vicki Lawrence Schultz. Film and television producer, David Niven Jr. And temporarily unable to make her usual grand entrance, our very own Kitty Carlisle. Here's the host of To Tell the Truth, Lynn Swann.
Oh, wonderful, thank you. My family, they're here.
Uh-huh.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome,
everyone.
Watching you go down those stairs, I was reminded of the fact that you took ballet lessons.
Yes.
And I intend to do a tour jeté coming down the stairs with you the next time.
Well, wonderful. If I had tripped, you would have known I didn't pay for all of them. I was only a fair dancer, yeah. Laugh at that, folks. Come on. Here we go.
I did.
Well, forget the humor. Let's get right to the story presented by our first team of challengers, all three of whom claim to be Heather Holyoke. And here is her story. Please read along with me. I, Heather Holyoke, am the youngest professional female ventriloquist in the country. I won the overall competition at the 1989 International Ventriloquist Convention. I performed 13 different voices for my 13 dummies, including my three friends you see here, Desert Rose, Ingrid the Buzzard, and the Cactus Kid. I saw a ventriloquist for the first time when I was 11, and I've been throwing my voice around ever since. Today, I'll take on the ultimate challenge. I'll do all the talking. When the panel asks a question of number one, I will give an answer as Desert Rose. When the question is directed to number two, I will respond as Ingrid the Buzzard. And when the question is posed to number three, I will respond as Cactus Kid. My two imposters won't say a single word. They are not dummies. But as a professional ventriloquist, I'm accustomed to working with silent partners. Signed, Heather Holyoke. We'll find out more about our versatile ventriloquist right after this. All right, panel. All three of these people claim to be Heather Holyoke, the multi-talented, multi-voiced ventriloquist. And I don't know if this is going to work.
Sure it will, Lynn. It'll work.
It will?
Oh, yeah. Just go ahead. It'll work.
Give it up, Lynn. Give it up.
Nice try, Lynn.
Don't listen to him, Lynn. You can do it. Okay. Kitty, start the question.
Thank you.
Thanks, Cricket.
How long are we going to have that?
All week.
Don't you like dogs?
I like dogs, but I'm not sure I like that voice of yours.
Oh, I'm sure.
Number one, how did you invent Desert Rose?
Oh, well, she's a creation of mine.
Uh-huh. And number two, how old were you when you found out you could do this?
Well, I was 11 years old.
11 years old. And number three, this one is called what? The third one?
The Cactus Kid.
Uh-huh, the Cactus Kid. And he's,
Time's up!
Oh, thank you.
David!
Cricket does this so well.
You're using up our time, Lynn.
Better than you do.
Okay, number one, who made your dummy for you?
Well, she was designed by myself, and she was made by a lady named Verna Finley.
Thank you. Number two, when you were at school, could you throw your voice around and could you get the teacher maybe to say things the teacher hadn't said?
Well, it's kind of fun. I do all sorts of stuff.
Number three, what naughty tricks did you play with your parents by pitting them one against the other when you could throw your voice around?
Well, I actually haven't done that yet, but it's kind of fun.
Vicki, your turn.
Okay. I'm fascinated by this. Thank
thank you.
Very good.
No, yeah, thanks. Number two, are you in school now?
Well, yes, I am.
And number three, what grade are you in?
I'm a senior in high school.
And number one, what do your friends think of all of this?
Well, a lot of my friends think it's really neat that a lot of people don't know I'm a ventriloquist.
You're
Vicky, thank you.
They are really great. Tell me, number one, do you ever think of your dummies as human?
Oh, sure. They're like an extension of my personality.
Yeah, number two, do they ever talk back to you?
Well, not necessarily.
Number three, what is the toughest letter for you to pronounce?
Well, that would have to be one of the vowels.
And
Martin, thank you.
Thank you.
Time's up. Oh, you're both so good. Now it's time to vote.
Vote? Yes, vote.
Yes, vote.
Okay, time to vote for either number one.
Or number two.
Oh, yes, number two or number three. Our team of challengers will receive $500 for each incorrect vote with a guarantee of $1,000. And if the panelists will complete, the team will receive $3,000.
Ooh, little dog biscuits. Okay.
Kitty, if you're ready to vote.
Oh, I
Cricket
am.
Really does like
yes,
you.
Yes, I love this spot, but I wish we could get rid of the dog.
Oh,
I wish you'd get rid of Lynn.
Oh, thank you, David.
No. They were all adorable, and I love the puppets, and they're all cute and dear. But I voted for number one.
Okay. David?
I thought they were all absolutely brilliant. I'm totally confused, but I have a sneaky feeling that number two is the real one because I was watching the way number two swallowed while the others were talking.
The swallow theory.
The swallow theory.
Sounds a little shallow to me, but it's okay, David. Vicky.
Sounds like a swan.
You know, I'm fascinated. I was just so sure I'm right, and so far we've all disagreed. And I thought number two was swallowing too much. No. So I don't know. I'm just sure it was number three.
Cricket, I think it's working.
Yes.
Go ahead, Monty.
Well, I ruled out number three because I think the toughest letters to pronounce are not the vowels. I think they're the M's and so on, where you have to put your lips together. So I didn't agree with her. And I thought number one was the most professional in her ventriloquy. So I picked number one.
Okay, the voting's done. Number one has two votes. Number two has one vote, as well as number three. Well, panel, time to find out who our real voice master is. Will the real Heather Holyoke please stand up? Vicky, you were right. Number three. Let's find out who your imposters are. Number one, your name and where you're from.
My name is Elizabeth Ely, and I'm an art student at the University of Southern California.
Terrific. Trojan. Number two, your name and what do you do?
My name is Lisa DeCaro, and I'm a horse trainer.
Wonderful. Well, there were three incorrect votes and $500 to vote. You will receive $1,500. Now, Heather, it's time for a little demonstration. You ready?
Ready.
I'm not going to be a part of this demonstration because you don't appreciate my superior talent. Is that on right?
Mm-hmm.
She backwards? That's cricket, by the way. Okay.
Well, howdy, dokes. My name is the Cactus Kid from Arizona.
And I'm freaking French, doggy.
And I am Heather Holyoke.
Don't worry if your song is not good enough for anyone else to hear, honey.
Just sing. No, Cactus doesn't really sing.
Just sing.
Cricket, you're giving me a headache.
Sing your song, honey.
That's all, folks.
Heather Holyoke. Wonderful. We'll be right back with a CIA hero right after this. We are back to tell the truth. Let's meet our next team of challengers.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Felix Rodriguez.
Number two.
My name is Felix Rodriguez.
Number three.
My name is Felix Rodriguez.
And panel, once again, it's up to you to locate the real Felix Rodriguez, and here is his story. Please read along with me.
I, Felix Rodriguez, was a CIA agent. I've been fighting communism since I was 17 years old. I was called upon for many covert operations against communists throughout the world, from the Bay of Pigs through Vietnam. I was infiltrated into Cuba 6 weeks before the Bay of Pigs invasion and was one of the few who escaped after the invasion failed. In 1967, as an advisor to the Bolivian army, I helped capture Che Guevara. I was the last person to interrogate him before he was executed. This picture is the only picture of Guevara alive in captivity. In 1985, I was asked by Lieutenant Colonel Oliver North to resupply the Contras in El Salvador. North failed to heed my warning that some of his partners were not to be trusted. My information was proven right during the Iran-Contra hearings. My book, entitled Shadow Warrior, tells all my experiences in the CIA and my fight against communism. Signed, Felix Rodriguez. Let's start at the far end with Monty Hall.
Number one, has your book been approved by the CIA?
Yes, we have to submit everything for their approval before it can be printed.
And number two, they didn't try to stop it?
No.
Number three, how did you escape after the invasion failed?
I was able to make it to the Venezuelan embassy.
And number one, who killed Che Guevara?
A Bolivian soldier who's anonymous now.
Thank you.
Monty, thank you. Vicky.
You've been fighting since you were 17 years old, number one. How did you get started?
Well, we left Cuba, and immediately I volunteered to join the forces because in Miami there was talk about planning an invasion, so all the Cubans were being organized.
So, number two, you left Cuba, you came to America, and you just joined up with the CIA. Is it that easy?
Number two,
yes.
Uh-huh. No, I was raised in Havana, and then I came to high school in New York. At the age of 19, I volunteered to do paramilitary work against the Castro regime, and we were shipped to Guatemala. I didn't know at the time that it was CIA-backed. It was Cuban-backed, as far as I knew, Cuban exile-backed. It was later on that I was recruited by the CIA because they were actually helping to form the entire operation.
Time's up, Vicky. Thank you. Cool. David.
Oh, all right. Thank you. Number one. How old were you when you were involved with the Bay of Pigs?
I was 19 years old.
Okay, number two, what island was used to train the pro-Cuban?
Swan Island.
Number three, who gave Swan Island?
Swan Island, I think it was used with a radio station. We were training Guatemala.
Number one, going back to the Swan Island, was it called Swan Island?
There was a radio station at Swan Island, but the troops were trained in Guatemala.
David, thank you. Kitty.
Gosh. Number two, where did you capture Che Guevara?
Che Guevara was captured in Bolivia, in a little town called La Higuera.
Uh-huh. And number three, was he intended to be executed on the spot like that?
I think it was a decision of the Bolivian High Command.
Uh-huh. And number one, what do you do now?
I am retired, I have a pension, and I'm in business.
And number two, who is
Kitty, thank you very much. Panel, that means your time is up, and time to vote for either number one, number two, or number three. And, Monty, we'll start with you.
This is not going to be easy. They all answered their questions quite well. I didn't think it was number two because he gave a rather long answer to one of the questions, and I thought the CIA were trained to speak very abruptly and in clipped tones, so I ruled him out. Number one looks like he'd be young enough to have been that age at the time, so I voted for number one.
Okay. Vicky.
Gosh, see, I was going to do number two because of that long answer. And I thought he really knew what he was talking about. But number one I ruled out. I'm not really sure why. I'm strictly going on a hunch. I'm saying number three.
Okay.
David? Well, strange as it may seem, I'm going for number two because of number two's long answer.
Well, I'm going for number three because he was rather scornful when Mr. Niven suggested that Swan Island was where they trained. And said, no, not at all. That was a place where it was a radio station. So I went for number three.
Okay. Well, all the votes are in. Number one and number two each have a single vote, while number three has two. Now let's find out who the real Shadow Warrior is. Will the real Felix Rodriguez please stand up?
Number three. Number three. Felix, I have to ask you, you know, being in Cuba during that Bay of Pigs incident and doing, I imagine, quite a bit more work there, did you ever, were you ever called upon to get close to Castro, to find, to shadow him?
Well, I actually volunteered to kill him back in when I was going to go back to Cuba. And it was approved at a point in time by the agency, and I even tried three times to infiltrate it with a rifle, and then it was canceled by the government.
Yeah. Oof.
But I tried.
Dangerous life you've lived. Let's find out who your imposters are. Number one, your name and what do you do?
Yes, my name is Mario Begiristain, and I'm creative director at an advertising agency.
Terrific. Number two, your name and what do you do?
My name is Jason Miranda, and I am a journalist, and I interview celebrities for foreign magazines in Europe.
Terrific. Thank you. There were two incorrect votes, so at $500 a vote, your team will receive $1,000. And thank you for playing to tell the truth. We'll be right back to play one-on-one with someone from our studio audience right after this. Now it's time to play one-on-one with someone from our studio audience. So, Burton, who do you have for us today?
Well, Lynn, today for you, we have Cynthia Nichols from San Diego, California.
Welcome, Cynthia. Nice to have you here. You're going to have a chance to play one-on-one. I want you to meet a woman who has two stories. Please welcome Pam Richards. Pam? Pam has two stories, only one of which is the truth. Now, Cynthia, if you spot that true story, you'll win $500. So, Pam, what's your first story?
I got fired for refusing to make coffee for my boss. I took her to court, and I won $10,000.
Now, that may or may not be the truth, so listen to her second story.
I won a car and a lottery. I turned it down because it wasn't union-made.
All right, panel, here's your chance to help Cynthia win $500. One question for each story. Kitty, we'll start with the coffee story.
Thank you. How did she damage you to the tune of $10,000, your boss?
She asked me to do a job that was not mine. It was not in the job description.
David.
Was $10,000 what you settled for or what you started out asking for? And if it wasn't what you started out asking for,
one
how much did you...
One question, David.
Okay.
Which one is it?
Which one is it? Is that what you settled for?
Yes.
Okay.
Vicky.
Why would it be improper to make coffee for your boss in an office? I mean, just as a fellow human being.
I was the one she picked on all the time to do it, and I got tired of it.
Okay. Pam, is it the truth that you didn't like your boss to begin with?
No.
Now, Cynthia, after all of that, that's the first story. Now listen to story number two about the car. Kitty.
What cars are not union made?
Honda Accords.
Thank you.
David.
Which lottery was this?
Ohio's.
Vicki.
What union are you a member of?
United Auto Workers.
Monty.
How many cars do you own?
I own one.
Okay, Cynthia. You've heard the cross-examination. Did Pam refuse to make coffee and receive $10,000, or did she turn down the car?
I'm going to go with the coffee, because I've heard of that happening a lot. So
okay.
I'll go with that one.
Pam, what is your true story?
To tell the truth, I turned down the car.
I'm sorry, Cynthia, but we do have a lovely gift for you. And Pam, you get $1,000 for stumping Cynthia in one-on-one. Now we have a piece of tape of you turning down the car. Let's take a look at it.
Well, there it is, Pam. Brand new Honda Accord. Or the cash and lots of free advice.
No.
She says no. Does that mean no car, Pam?
I'm a union member.
You turned down the car. So what are you driving now? What do you have?
I have an Imperial that was given to me for a year. And then in the future, I have cars that are going to be given to me, but I don't have them in my possession yet.
How many cars will be given to you?
In the future, I'll have three. Two to keep forever and one to drive for the year.
Boy, that's a better deal than you get with Monty Hall.
You want to keep what you got or try for Kirk number three?
I'll keep what I have. Thanks.
She'll keep it. Listen, thank you very much for playing. We'll be right back after these words.
Buzzer presents another profile of an African-American great, Odetta. Born Odetta Holmes in Birmingham, she was a classically trained opera singer, but still faced racial challenges as a young adult. After experiencing folk music, she learned guitar and became one of the greatest voices of the civil rights movement. In 71, Odetta inspired on What's My Line.
Take off your blindfolds and meet Odetta.
This episode is coming up next on Buzzer.
Thank you for being here. We'll see you later on To Tell the Truth. Bye.
This is Burton Richardson speaking for To Tell the Truth, a Mark Goodson television production.
See you tomorrow.
We love you. We'll see you here on the Family Field.
Show until next time. This is Peter Tomarkin on behalf of the Bukkake Rug saying thanks for pressing your luck. Bye-bye.
So anyway, we have just 10 seconds to say goodbye. We'll see you tomorrow. So long.
Bye-bye. Yeah.
We got 5 seconds.
Oh, no. We have 3, 2, 1.
Bye. Bye.